So that was fun. It was actually a ton of fun. I had the best time. Steve Harvey, nicest person ever.
Turn left onto North Spalding Avenue, then turn left onto Rosewood Avenue.
Like I mentioned before, to meet him in person. And
turn left onto North Genesee Avenue, then turn left onto
Rosewood
Avenue.
To see him coming out onto the stage. I was sitting next to a bunch of kids from UCLA. This lady won't talk, stop talking. Okay, lady, I'm gonna turn left onto Rosewood Avenue. Sitting next to a bunch of kids from UCLA. They probably didn't even recognize him. So he's still coming from the back, and I'm like, it's crazy because I've never seen him before. It was a really nice time, he's a cool guy, and he talks to the audience in between takes, during commercial break and all that stuff. Yeah, I really had the nicest time. We were there for since 9, and it's now 3. We wrapped up just after 2. It's a Mark Burnett show, kind of like Shark Tank. I hope it gets picked up for like another season. I think it will, because Steve Harvey has a lot of fans, and I think his fans are loyal to him. The streets are very narrow. Okay, I'll show you this, where we're going. I'm leaving Hollywood. I'm still within Hollywood now. I'm on my way out. Oh, I'm hungry. I didn't want any food on set, even though we were told beforehand to bring small disposable snacks, containers, blah, 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 blah. When we get there, they were like, no food on set at all. You have anything to eat? Eat it now. No, I'm not gonna eat everything now. Like, at like 9 a.m. You told me I'm gonna be here for 7 hours, so I brought several snacks for throughout the day. Anyway, I did manage to eat like a banana. Thank goodness. Here with all the trees, isn't it? Still in West Hollywood. It's probably another name for it. The Grove something something. Because we're close to the Grove. The shopping center. Is that a gas station? No. Almost looks like a Shell though, doesn't it? With the colors. Put my phone on the steering wheel for directions. It blocks the gas. It blocks some of the things. And I'm not seeing if I need gas or not, or whatever. 350 and 315, same price. No, I wanna pay less. I always wanna pay less. Gas station 1 minute away. It's supposed to be 30 cents cheaper. I I think it's worth it, isn't it? Don't you think? Don't ya? I'm eating boiled eggs. Good thing you can't smell them. Lately I've been craving boiled eggs. You know, when my gas thing goes red, when the warning light goes off, not even red or orange, I can't even breathe. I literally panic. The gas station that I've decided to go to is a mile and a half away from where I am now. According to this thing, 5 minutes, and I feel like, will I make it? This truck is very heavy on gas, and I'm really embarrassed if I don't make it. I think I'll make it, but I'm just like, oh, I can't even eat this egg now. I think I'll have to wait, focus on my breathing. 1 mile away, 4 minutes. The light's gonna close. I always tell myself, go to the first gas station, you see. I literally can't breathe, oh my god. I always tell myself, go to the first gas station, you see, get some gas, and then drive to a cheaper one, because it's such a cheap skate. And then fill up. But do I do that? Not as often as I should. Okay, 4 minutes. Please, Lord, no more lights. Can't breathe. Driving faster, but apparently when you drive faster it's gonna chow your gas even faster. So I have to drive slowly. But these guys, I mean seriously, you're driving at 20 miles an hour right now. An hour. That's slower than slow. The road's going up. Ah! Half a mile. I should show you how much gas I have now. Damn it. I'll show you. Oh my god, I'm just gonna go in here. Already there. 1 minute away. I didn't go there because it was full. 300 feet. have arrived? No, I haven't. Damn it. She says I've arrived, but I don't see. Oh my God. I have to turn a freaking round. Unbelievable. I'm gonna run out of gas for sure. There was one on the left, but the one I was going to was supposed to be like the next block, and it just didn't happen. Now I'm driving extra for no reason. Damn it. Okay, Brooke, calm down. I don't know, I just drove over the curb right now. Ugh. What would be funny is if I didn't make it to the gas station, even though I just drove past it. I passed so many gas stations. It's not even funny. Okay, now we have to wait for all these people who are not moving even though the light is green. Oh, Western, that's the gas station. It's really, I think, when I was driving to the shop. And I said I always go to that one. I get in. Oh, and it's not full. Thank you, Christ. Success! Sometimes I stress so much about gas that I forget which side my tank is in. Okay. Thank you, stars. God is on my side. Oh. Shut the windows. I'm from South Africa, I gotta be safe. I love my country, but you gotta be careful over there. So, all these random people lingering about the gas station and stuff. All of a sudden, my light is not even flashing. I have more gas now. That's the kind of stuff that like tricks you and you think, oh, I'll be good for a while. No, you won't. Before you know it, you get on the freeway and you're screwed. Nobody know. I'll stop at 30. How many gallons? 10. 30 bucks. Okay. On 12 gallons. Oh my God, so much. Okay. 35 bucks, 12 gallons. When you get gas, do you empty the hose? You know how it's like this and then it goes into your tank? Do you lift up the bottom and just make sure that all the gas is in there? I feel like I got robbed. 35 bucks for 12 gallons. Some people can fill up their tanks with less than that and it lasts them longer than mine does. If you do the math, that's not fair. But it is what it is. Therefore, what are you gonna do? I'm just so glad I can breathe now. That's all. It is well with my soul. Let's get out of here. We ride, we ride. We ride.